you just come to me? Would you just come to me? Once you're done running around, would you simply come? Would you simply come to me? Know that I am good. Just know that I am good. Just know that I am good to you. Now let me hold you. Here. Oh,
into your heart. We ask that you would take us into your heart right now, that we can see with your eyes and love with the heart that you have. Thank you, Jesus. We're now going into a time of praying and interceding for the nation of Korea from the Word of God. As we read and pray through the scripture, please join us as we declare the truth and hope of salvation over the nation of Korea. Stand in your authority to intercede with God's heart from His word for this nation. Tonight we'll be reading from Isaiah 61, verses 1 through 7. If you have your Bible, I invite you to join with us. Isaiah 61, verses 1 through 7. Isaiah 61, verse 1. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for prisoners. Lord, you have provided freedom for the people of this nation through the anointing of those who have been set free already. Chosen this way to release the light into the darkness from those who already have seen it. We pray that your church will go outside her walls into the streets, businesses, schools, subways with renewed hearts of compassion for the hopeless, a compassion like yours as you saw your people lost and harassed. We see freedom bursting forth as your people go out to work, out to play, with eyes open to seek out the brokenhearted. Call out your mouthpieces to proclaim for freedom, your freedom and salvation in every area of society.
Sovereign
Of depression, being broken in anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones to set the captives free with you. Send out your anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones to set the captives free. Captives free, would you send out your anointed ones? Send out your anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones to set the captives free. Would you send out your anointed ones? Send out your anointed ones. Send out your anointed ones to set the captives free.
Instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. Lord, let your church not hold back the truth, for the wages of sin are truly death, and we are truly in the year of your favor, because you've made a way to set us free from that death. We declare the church flowing into the city with compassion and strength to lift up the burdens of the brokenhearted, to speak life and comfort to those who mourn, and provide for the needs of those who are grieving. We see the chains of bitterness and hopelessness falling to the ground all over Korea as you minister through the hands and feet of your church. To you, Korea, God says, open your hands and receive a garment of praise to replace your robe of despair. See my provision coming through the hands of my people. Wiping the tears from your eyes, Korea. The ashes of past destruction weighing down the heads of generation after generation are being replaced with a crown of beauty. Beautiful are the crowns of those who have been set free from bitterness. Lord, as you send them out to proclaim this good news.
People, they are coming alive.
51, verses 3 and 4. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. They will rebuild the ancient ruins and restore the places long devastated. They will renew the ruined cities that have been devastated for generations. Lord, you are establishing your people as oaks of righteousness in Korea right now. Grow them tall to shout your goodness all over Asia and the world. We prophesy this nation continuing to rise as an example of your provision and blessing as the people turn to you for salvation. Thank you, Father, that you will not allow the ruins and bitterness of historical offenses to remain, but in your sovereignty, you will restore these places of devastation and bitterness to bring back unity that has been lost for generations. We know the power to display your splendor is not found behind walls of protection, but only through your rebuilding of devastated places. Do it here in Korea for all the world to see. You desire restoration of every devastation. We prophesy your rebuilding and restoration of the unity that has been lost. Do what only you can do. We see mighty oaks of righteousness rising up all over this peninsula.
Will send
nation that will stand. You're raising from these ruins. You're raising from these ashes. A nation that will stand. A nation that will stand. You're raising from these ruins. You're raising from these ashes. A nation that will stand. A nation that will stand. Nothing to be for you,
and we look to you with every moment and every step of the way. We look to you for the building. There is no more bitterness. There's no more ruins in this nation. For you are doing a new thing. For you are doing a new thing. There is no
brokenness. Through this pain I will confess you are always good. Deserts will bloom in the light of your love. Valleys make room for the river of God.
Deserts will bloom.
Deserts will bloom. Never run dry, never run dry, never run dry.
not with striving, because you never run dry and you are our source. But we come to you with assurance of who you are and who we are in you. And from that place of assurance, into a time of intercession through prayer topics. Tonight we'll be praying for Korea, specifically for the kingdom culture to be established here. For tonight, we'll actually come from a place of zoomed in smallness and then out. So think small and we'll get big. So please come into agreement with me and pray along with the prayer points. Neighborhood or the district of Seoul, the one that comes to mind, maybe it's your neighborhood, maybe it's where you work, maybe it's a place you used to live. Lord, show us your vision for the areas that you've put on our hearts tonight. Let us see with clarity that what you desire to bring out of this land is greater than what we can imagine. We declare changes coming to these areas as a result of your work of salvation. Let the landscapes change as you draw people to yourself. Where there is hopelessness and darkness, break through with your grace and your light. With our powers, with our prayers, move your heart to act. And with our obedience, you move our feet to go shine your light. Uncover the acts of darkness that have held the people of this nation captive to hatred or fear or shame. Bring all corruption into the light and clean out the dark corners to rebuild the ruins. You desire this area to resemble your kingdom as it is in heaven. Show us what that looks like. Open our eyes to see your hand at work. Let's pray.
Thank you.
vision, Lord, to see things like you do. We declare that from each gate of this city, your glory will flow into the city as you walk in. Lord, when you walk into this city, it is made new. Let it be from the gates of your church that your light flows through the streets as we catch your vision and your heart to cultivate the city for your glory. We pray for the city leaders in Seoul to have a vision that is in alignment with yours. Demolish the corruption that would hinder your kingdom being established. We prophesy that all destructive motives are being rooted out from the highest leaders to the daily city workers. Bring a fresh desire to renew We desire to know your heart, to see your vision for this peninsula. Your desire is unity, wholeness, and shalom as your kingdom is established here. Establish your kingdom in us and give us your heart. Lord, bring shalom. Bring salvation as a mighty river flowing through the whole peninsula. And bring freedom from bitterness and offense of generations as you heal hurts into peace. We prophesy your church throughout the whole peninsula, stirred to pray and move in obedience for the establishment of your kingdom in unity across arbitrary borders of politics. Bring your people together as one, first in prayer, then in action, and finally as forerunners into the political unity that we've all been praying for. Let's pray.
Displays all your fears. To the end. trust in your name. We trust in your promises. You have never failed us, not once. And we thank you, God, that your promises over Korea, but God, over this district here in Seoul, over this city, over this nation, and over the whole Korean Peninsula, all your promises still stand. We thank you, God, that this is your nation. This is a nation that you have claimed as your own. Lord God, you have lifted this nation up from the ruins and up from the ashes. And we know, God, that you're not finished yet. Lord God, you will not relent until you see the fullness of the measure of your promises that you've spoken over this nation. Lord God, we will see this nation becoming one once again. We will see the north being rebuilt up once again. We will see a nation that has been divided for decades being made one, being made whole once again. We thank you, God, for what you're doing in this hour. We place our trust and we place our hope in your promises. We love you, Lord. We lift up the one name that can do all things. We thank you, Lord, and we pray all these things in your precious name. Amen.